Hello, welcome students. In previous video, we have started lesson number 10, cell and cell organelles. There you have studied the components of cell, that is cell wall, plasma membrane and cytoplasm, and also the organelles of cell, that is nucleus and endoplasmic reticulum. Today we are going to study the remaining cell organelles. Golgi complex. It is made up of 5 to 8 hollow and flat sacs placed parallel to each other. These sacs are called cisternae and are filled with different enzymes. Enzymes are nothing but proteins and they act as catalyst. The proteins coming from endoplasmic reticulum are enclosed in vesicles which come towards Golgi complex via cytoplasm. They fuse with the formation phase of the Golgi membranes and empty their contents in the cisternae. See this, in this Golgi complex, the structure, tubular structure you can see in the picture, that is cisternae. And the round shaped structure, those are vesicles. The proteins whatever synthesized in endoplasmic reticulum, they are again carried towards the Golgi complex and once again they are packed in the Golgi complex. As they pass through the cisternae, they are chemically modified with the help of enzymes. They are again packed in the vesicles. So the cisternae work like a packing department that packs and distributes substances. So this Golgi complex is a packing department. Now functions of Golgi complex. Golgi complex is the secretory organ of the cell. Second, it modifies, sorts and packs materials synthesized in the cell and dispatches them to various targets like plasma membrane, lysosomes, etc. Third, it produces vacuoles and secretory vesicles. Fourth, it helps in the formation of cell wall, plasma membrane and lysosomes. So now, introduction to scientist. Camillo Golgi described the Golgi complex for the first time. He won the Nobel Prize of 1906 along with Santiago Cajal for the study of structure of nervous system. Now the next organelle is lysosomes. Lysosomes are simple single membrane bound sacs filled with digestive enzymes. Functions of lysosome. First one, immune system. It destroys viruses and bacteria that attack the cell. Second, demolition squares. It is destroys worn out cellular organelles and organic debris. Debris means the waste materials. And this process is called autolysis. Autolysis means the destruction of tissues by their own enzymes. Third point, suicide bags. When a cell becomes old or is damaged, lysosomes burst, breaks, and enzymes digest their own cells. Fourth point, during starvation. Starvation means fasting. Lysosomes digest stored proteins, fats, etc. Mitochondria. Each cell requires energy and this energy is produced in the mitochondria. Therefore, they are called as powerhouse of the cell. Under electron microscope, a mitochondrion is seen as a double membrane structure. The outer membrane is porous, means holes are there, and the inner membrane is deeply folded. These folds are called cristae. You can see in the picture the folds, they are called as cristae. The inner cavity is filled with proteinaceous, means containing protein, gel-like matrix containing ribosomes, phosphate granules and DNA. Therefore, it can produce its own proteins. Mitochondria contain their own DNA. With the help of enzymes, mitochondria oxidize carbohydrates and fats in the cell. See here, oxidize means what? Combining with oxygen. Carbohydrates and fats, they combine with oxygen in the cell. The energy released in this process is stored in the mitochondria in the form of ATP. ATP means what? Adenosine triphosphate. Now, functions of mitochondria. To produce energy, rich compound ATP. Second, synthesis, that is making of proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, etc. by using the energy in ATP. Next organelle is vacuoles. Vacuoles are the storage sacs for solid or liquid contents. They don't have any typical shape or size. The structure of the vacuole changes according to the need of the cell. Vacuole is bound by a single membrane. Now the functions of vacuoles. First one, to maintain the osmotic pressure, means minimum pressure applied to regulate the flow of solvents through semi-permeable membrane. To maintain the osmotic pressure of the cell, this is the first function. Now second, to store metabolic byproducts and end products. Third point, in animal cell, they store waste products and food, while in amoeba, it stores food before digestion. Fourth point, in plant cell, vacuoles are full of cell sap and provide turgidity, rigidity to them. Plastids. Why are plant leaves green and flowers red, yellow, orange or blue? The organelle which gives such colors is present only in the plant cells. It is called plastid. Plastids have double membrane and are of two types. First one is leucoplast and the second one is chromoplast. Leucoplast means white or colorless plastids and chromoplast means colored plastids. Chloroplasts can get converted into other types of chromoplasts. Example, raw green tomatoes turn red due to breakdown of chlorophyll and synthesis of lycopene. Now, the color of the plant part and pigment. Green, that is in leaves are green and pigment is chlorophyll. Orange color, that is example carrot and the pigment is carotene. Yellow color, that is pigment is xanthophyll. And purple, blue color, that is anthocyanin. And dark pink, that is example beet and the pigment is betalains. Chloroplast. Chloroplast are important for the photosynthesis process that takes place in the leaves. Chlorophyll in chloroplast traps solar energy and converts it to chemical energy. Stroma in the chloroplast contain enzymes, DNA, ribosomes and carbohydrates that are necessary for photosynthesis. See here, chloroplasts, they contain their own DNA. So, functions of chloroplast. Chloroplast converts solar energy to chemical energy, that is production of food. Second, chromoplasts give different colors टू फ्लावर्स एंड फ्रूट्स. थर्ड वन, ल्यूकोप्लास्ट आर इन्वॉल्व इन द सिंथेसिस एंड स्टोरेज ऑफ फूड लाइक स्टार्च, ऑयल्स एंड प्रोटीन्स. माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड प्लास्टिड्स कैन प्रोड्यूस प्रोटीन्स एज वेल एज रेप्लिकेट themselves as they have their own DNA and ribosomes. After studying the cell and cell organelles, you must have come to know that all the functions in plant and animal cells are taking place smoothly due to the cell organelles. Such developed cells are called eukaryotic cells. Last year you have studied prokaryotic cells of bacteria. Let's now compare both the types of cells, eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. The first point, in eukaryotic cell the size is 5 to 100 micrometer and prokaryotic cell is 1 to 10 micrometer. Second point, the number of chromosomes are more than 1 in eukaryotic cell and only 1 in prokaryotic cell. And the eukaryotic cell nucleus is with nuclear membrane, nucleolus and nucleoplasm. And in prokaryotic cell, nucleoid resembling nucleus. And mitochondria and plastids are present in eukaryotic cell. And prokaryotic cell don't have membrane bound cell organelles. And examples of eukaryotic cell are, they are present in highly evolved unicellular and multicellular plants and animals. And prokaryotic cell example is bacteria. I hope you understood the topic. So for better understanding, read the topic once again and do the given homework.